Okay, it's Dave here. I'm just back with my little three-board mini microcomputer prototyping platform type thing. There it is all assembled. Now I've got the E2 RAM socket in there. Okay, I got all the keyboard and the LEDs and the LCDs and the, so this is my working area here now, right here, breadboarding area. The rest of this, where the two boards are stacked here, you don't have to do anything to except for, you know, download the program. Okay, so here's the back, and now I've got the CPU on there, so let's see if we can just get right in there. The toughest part about using this kind of a CPU is the soldering, to be able to solder that little puppy on there. So what I do is I use a special solder. It's this stuff here. Very, very fine. Okay, and just as a comparison to regular solder, see if this will show up here. There's my regular solder and the small stuff below it. So very, very fine. Plus my soldering iron tip is very, 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 very fine on this one too. So I don't know if it'll actually be able to focus on that. Let's see if we can get it to focus. Come on, focus. There you go. Put my hand a little closer to it. But it's a very fine, fine tip. So anyways, there it is. I'm not going to power it up yet because I've still got to upload the program into it. But there she is. 8 keys. 2 line by 8 character LCD. My power supply. Red-green LED. Okay. 20 megahertz crystal PIC16F876 microcontroller programmed so that it will output 8 pins here that I can use. So I showed that in the last video. So I've got 1 E2 RAM in underneath here. If I wanted to add 3 more, all I have to do is just put them on the breadboard area here, and that would give me 4 times the memory storage. But the idea will be is that I can just put a PIC processor, an A version, 16F876A-I/SP. It's a special processor. It runs at 20 megahertz. Most programmers don't program it, so this will be a simple fix for that. So I'll just put the socket right here, and my power supply will have a switch on it. I just turn it on and off. When I want to dump the program in, I'll pick which program I want to dump, and this little unit will program it, verify it, and so on. Now I'll put a serial level conversion chip on here, like a max 232 over here in the breadboarding area, and the 2 pins on the end here are the serial ports. So we've got transmit and receive, and this little baby will go right up to 115k, so pretty fast. If you want to interface to USB, there's a USB dongle you can buy that will just solder right on to that TTL level without having to put a converter chip in there. So just as I made a couple of these, hold on, I got another one here. Gotta move my camera a little bit. There we go. So I got another set of those boards right here, which I broke down into the three pieces because I want to make something that's handheld. Okay, like so, handheld, So there'll be this piece here would be basically just take this piece and bend it right around to the back. Of course, you don't need as much space in here. And it would actually be able to fit inside the same little box, a little clear box with a display on it. So all I have to do is drill holes that would allow these switches to protrude through, and the inside of the box would sit on top of the LCD. Anyways, but not for this project. I got a couple other ones I want to make with this little design, but basically got a couple. One of my buddies wants a little video switcher that will do it off of audio, so we'll be able to switch the cameras according to the audio. So I needed a little display and a keyboard that would allow him to get into it. So basically I'll make that unit on one of these as well, and I can just make these your standard wire terminals fit into these end things here, and you can gang as many as you want together. I think you can put to what, 7 here. So there you go. Next video I'll put up on this one here will be once it's programmed and I got the programming part of it working, so I can just show you these routines that are going to be used in this are just going to be copied from this, basically. Where is it? Here we are. This thing here, if you look at it carefully, it's more or less the same thing. Actually, if I just went like this and showed you the backs of them, see, they're more or less the same. Just this one here is dedicated to doing something, and this one here is more for making whatever you want. But they both have the same CPU on them. Different kind of power supply than this baby. But you'll see they are virtually the same. Actually, I got this guy backwards. So, same display, same CPU, same switches. Same kind of setup, just a different purpose. So, now, the other thing I haven't mentioned yet is that I actually made these circuit boards myself. Where is it here? Somewhere sitting close to me here is a folder. Anyways, here it is. So here's a folder, and inside the folder is the board layout for that. So this is what I actually created this from, was a transparency basically onto a circuit board, and then etched and drilled the circuit board so that it would leave the pattern. So you can see it there. I don't know if you can see it very well, but see that? That's the pattern for that. And then after I've etched it and drilled it and everything, I clean off the special coating that's on the copper with an SOS pad and put the unit together. And as I showed you, this is what I end up with. It's pretty well made. Thanks for watching. It's Dave here, over and out.